All right, and welcome to our first edition of Game Wild. This has been a long time in the works. My name is Joe, aka Roughhouse Plays. That is my Twitch handle. You can catch me playing all different types of games, from card games, first-person shooters, RPGs, pretty much anything that's interesting me at the time. And my schedule right now, I'm working on changing it, but I try to be on Tuesday nights, Thursday nights, and Friday nights. So catch me out there and check out some of the videos I've already done. I think you'll enjoy them. You get to see what I'm all about. And then obviously you can catch me on all the fun different social media outlets. You got Facebook, you got Instagram, you got Twitter. So I try to be active in all those, and hopefully you like the content that I put out on there as well. And I do have a YouTube channel, although it is not as striking as my partner's YouTube channel, which I'm about to introduce him to you as well here. So you know, SJW shit just works. I'm gonna introduce you. I want you to talk about your stuff real quick here, buddy.
So
go for it.
All right, my name's Justin, also known as like Roughhouse Head over here. Shit just works. And this podcast has been a long time coming. Me and Joe have talked about this for a little while now. We're trying to basically just kind of start a fun gaming news podcast, specifically some esports in there as well. It doesn't seem like there's a whole lot of people talking about esports right now, but esports is definitely a thing. It's going to be a thing for a long time to come. So I do, yes, have a YouTube channel. Thank you for the kind words there, Joe. And I've been working on it for a little while now, probably about 3 months or so. Primarily card game content, a lot of Legends of Runeterra stuff, some Hearthstone stuff on there. I'll probably end up, you know, putting up some other various videos on God knows what other games I play. I do also stream like Roughhouse over here. So right now, Monday and Fridays at 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. and then Saturdays at 10 a.m. if I decide that I'm going to wake up on time for the stream, which did not happen successfully today, but it is what it is. Social media, obviously, like Joe said as well, Instagram, all that good stuff, Twitter. You can find me as @shitjustworks. Sometimes it's spelled with a C. Sometimes it's spelled without a C. Depends on if it was available or if their filter thingy would allow me to use that word.
Yeah, I do have to say I didn't think that through, did you? When you were trying to make that name, you're like, you know, it sounds cool, but then marketing it and getting it on certain platforms,
yeah,
a little bit more of a challenge than you expected.
What sucks is I remember the first one that I made the name on, like whatever platform it was. I don't know if it was like Blizzard or something, but they allowed the SHIT. So yeah, I was like, oh, okay, this isn't a problem. But then almost every other one was like, nah, nope, you're not able to use it. I think Twitter allows the SHIT. Twitter allows pretty much everything. So
yeah, Twitter's a lot of fun, guys, and I'm sure we'll have some great in the coming weeks as we release these podcasts. And another thing to mention, this is going to be a weekly podcast. We're going to try to do up to date news, stuff like that. But if we find things that interest us in the gaming world, we're also going to bring that to the forefront as well. But we do want to try to hit all different types of aspects of gaming, as SJW did say. So we hope you enjoy this. And if you do, as I hear with every podcast I've ever listened to, give us 5 stars, write something nice. We appreciate everybody who listens to this podcast.
Wait, is smash that like button appropriate? Can we say that? Is that
well, there is no like button. Maybe in certain podcast apps, obviously the big boy is Apple, so that's the one that you're probably going to give.
Sorry, so no smash that like button on Apple.
No, that's more for our Twitch stuff. And if you check out my last video, my title was "Smash That Like Button." This is the way for the Mandalorian, which was a smash hit apparently.
Oh yeah.
So, you know, I think now that people have gotten to know us a little bit, we should probably dive right in. And so what's going wild in the game atmosphere this week? So first on the docket, one like interesting article I found was we're in 2020 now, and a lot of stuff's coming out about what happened in gaming in 2019, the year that was, things of that nature. And one article that just popped up on my feed when I was like, my God, was freemium games, as I like to call them. Some people call them other things. I call them freemium. And actually, how much revenue these games have brought into companies. And I know you've looked at the article, so it's not going to be a surprise if I ask you, could you guess which one it was? But I'll tell you guys this. I did do this with him
before the podcast,
and he got it wrong. I just
wanted to take that. I was close. All right, give me a break. I was close.
He was close because the one that he said was League of Legends, which actually came in fourth.
I should have got it.
Came in fourth at revenue. But as everyone knows, the number one game is Fortnite. And that came in at $1.8 billion.
I hate that. I hate Fortnite, by the way.
Hate is a strong word. I'm going to tell you that we're going to get a lot of Fortnite players probably listening to this, especially if we're going to be doing some esports stuff. So I wouldn't go the hate route.
It's a love, love-hate relationship. I just can't get on with building houses while I'm trying to shoot somebody.
I'm trying to defend myself with while I'm building a log cabin. You know what I mean? So it's something in which like blows my mind that this company brought in $1.8 billion in revenue. Now, they don't go into too much detail about what revenue, so money from esports, you know, things of that nature, what actually is from people buying things for the game, you know, like outfits, skins, things of that nature. But I'll tell you what, that's a hell of a lot of skins.
Well, let's go through too.
Revenue of $1.8 billion.
Well, yeah, because it's free. Like the game itself is free, so the fact they even made that much is insane.
Right, the game is free, and that's what makes it even more interesting because it's free, and they sell you little add-ons, and that's where you're making your money. That's where the, you know, the nut's being made, and that is just blows my mind. And all of them, it looks like that are in the top 10 list are in the billion.
So revenue, yeah, so we got Fortnite with the 1.8 that Joe just mentioned. We got, which I've never even heard of this game, Dungeon Fighter Online by Nexon, who I've also not heard of that publisher. Have you heard of that publisher?
No.
That's supposedly an RPG. I feel like that's a mobile RPG. That's like one of those things you always have a pop-up ad for in YouTube.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Try.
Yeah, it's try exactly what
God's
it is.
God's love. Build somebody up as a god and then shrink them down.
That's 1.6 billion. And then we have Honor of Kings, which I have seen in those YouTube ads. I know that game. Mm-hmm. That's from Tencent, which we'll actually get into a little bit later, some more on Tencent. That made also $1.6 billion. That's a MOBA, which for you non-acronym-enabled people out there, MOBA is Multiplayer Online Battle Arena. So, and which League of Legends is also a multi... Oh, God, I'm not saying it again. It's a MOBA. And I was going to go for it again.
That's fine.
League of Legends is number four, also made by Tencent. It's funny how they put Riot Games and Tencent in there, though, even though Tencent owns Riot Games. Like, I don't understand why they made that distinction. That's $1.5 billion. Honestly, yep. I
like because they both publish it. I mean, they both probably have some mix in it. So even though they're owned by it, but Riot Games is that like when you see a game from EA, but then you see the like the Canadian publisher.
Oh, I get
like
what you're saying. Yeah,
was working on the Call of Duty or whatever game.
Okay, yeah, I gotcha.
You know what I mean? All that stuff. So
and then we have everybody's grandmother's favorite game, Candy Crush Saga, and that is another $1.5 billion. That to me is so stupid that Candy Crush Saga made the same amount of money as League of freaking Legends. League of Legends is like this mind-blowing, you know, across the world game that has blown up esports, and then you just have Candy Crush Saga. We're matching pieces of candy and making them explode. Like, come
exactly.
on. Like, what have games come to? Pokemon you know, Go is, yeah. Is next. Or go ahead, sorry.
Yeah, no, so I mean I you know, with Pokemon Go, I've played that one myself and actually had a lot of fun with it when it first came out. I still remember like when I was in Maine on a vacation, I'd walk around because I think that's the coolest part is like you go to new unique areas. If you're there, you can play the game and see what yep. Pokemon or what was around there. It was just fun to walk around. I still remember like taking a night and probably spent like 20 minutes just walking around, you know, the beaches and stuff in Maine and trying to just collect Pokemon. And it was just fun to do. And
how long ago did it come out again?
Oh my god.
It's like a few years now, right?
Yeah. 3 or 4 years. Yeah, and it was huge. Like, there's a plaza near me and the Verizon. I used to go in there to do stuff for phones, and they would be like, "Oh man, right over here at the food area, there's a like a rest station or something for the Pokemon." So people would be going to that area all the time because they could like recharge their Pokemon or whatever. But you know, so I'm not as surprised that's on there.
No, I'm
So
not
what?
either. Oh, I have a funny story though from when I first
Oh no,
started,
talk.
which honestly, it's less of a funny story and more of like a nostalgic type feeling. When this game, literally, I'm talking the week that this game came out, Pokemon Go, and nobody knew who Niantic was. The only reason they knew who they were was because of Pokemon. And I remember going to a bar in East Greenwich, Rhode Island. Literally, everybody at the bar, everybody from 60 years old to like 20 years old, and I say 20 because obviously there's people that, you know, had fake IDs to get in. They all were playing Pokemon Go. Like, literally, everybody's at a bar, walking around the bar, like, staring at their phone, like, wondering what Pokemon are nearby. At that moment, I literally felt like I was in, like, a freaking Pokemon game because everybody was, like, a trainer trying to catch Pokemon in a bar. And that was the most ridiculous feeling I've ever experienced in my life for absolutely every person in a building to be playing the same game. At a bar, too, no less. So,
Yep, well, it happens.
it was definitely an interesting game when it came out. So, we have a couple other random ones. Crossfire by Smilegate. Never heard of them. That's a shooter, apparently. Again, probably one of those random mobile ones. 1.4 billion. Fate Grand Order, which sounds kind of familiar. I don't know if you know that one. No.
No, not.
That's RPG. 1.2 billion. Game for Peace, again by Tencent. Blowing up this list with a shooter. 1.2. And then Last Shelter Survival by Longtech, IM30.net strategy game, 1.1 million. So, it's a hell of a list. It's a hell of a list.
Yeah, and I mean, you know, just to give credit where credit's due, we found this article on Game Crate. We will, in the podcast notes, share out the links to all of the articles we found so you guys can read it and check it out for yourselves, because we're just doing highlights and going through stuff and just giving our take on it. And you know, it's funny when I look at this, the biggest thing that I think about when I see a list like this is there was a South Park episode about this, where like how crazy freemium games are, because are freemium games really free? You know, and it came captured that aspect of
It's all up here.
self-control. Well, yeah, self-control and saying I want to be the best, and you know, paying to be the best in some of these games. Granted, I know Fortnite tries to balance that, and you can't. It's not a pay-to-win type style game, and I'm sure that there's a bunch of them on this list that are not pay-to-win, and I'm sure there are a couple. I'm not familiar with a lot of them, but like a game like Pokemon Go, for example, you could spend tons of money on it just to evolve your Pokemon, get incubators or whatever it was that you had. I haven't played it in a long time, but I remember being able to buy stuff to put Pokemon in and things like that. So it's just amazing. And I've been sucked into it too. One of the biggest games I used to play, I used to work in Boston, so I used to take the train all the time. So phone games were big for me. And my big game go-to was actually Marvel Puzzle Quest. So it was a puzzle game, kind of like Candy Crush, but you actually got superheroes and they had special abilities that you could use, things like that. But it got to a point where you're spending money because you wanted different heroes. You wanted to upgrade your heroes. You wanted to have the coolest Spider-Man. You wanted to have the coolest
Well,
Wolverine,
you know,
you know.
there's a lot of like legal stuff happening because of that too. I don't know if you heard about the whole Rocket League thing.
No, I haven't. What's going on with Rocket League?
They had changed the way that like crates or something. I honestly don't know like exactly what it
Oh,
was.
stuff like EA's been doing.
Yeah, like
Blizzard's been doing
EA,
it as well.
there's a lot of consideration being taken now on the free to play games and actually getting those drops and those things that you are paying for in the game, like crates and stuff like that.
Yeah, I think that one of the biggest things was EA had a big issue with that as well because of a Darth Vader type situation, I think,
Darth Vader.
or something. I think so. Something like that in a Battlefront 2. It was a big deal or something. I can't remember exactly what it was about. But if anyone remembers that, comment to us in any of our apps that you're catching us up on now, whether it's on YouTube or, you know.
Yeah, and like Joe said, all these articles will also be, if you're catching this on YouTube, all the articles will be below in the description on YouTube, any of our sources, basically. So, but yeah, the and actually, we'll probably get into this a little bit later, too, when we start talking about Tencent, but even Legends of Runeterra, that new card game that's coming out, They're trying to take a focus on, like, Hearthstone was free to play, quote unquote, and Hearthstone's not free to play. Like, you need to buy packs in order to, like, get cards. Yeah, you have to. And everybody kind of doesn't really like Blizzard that much because of that, because it's a very money hungry game, it kind of seems like. And Riot's trying to take the alternate route and truly try to make Legends of Runeterra much more accessible and free to play as far as that's concerned. So.
And it should be.
Yeah, I agree.
If you're going to make any game free, you shouldn't be like, hey, the way you have an advantage is by spending hundreds of dollars on the game.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So I don't buy into the free stuff, but I have been hooked before. They have gotten their clutches into me.
Oh, yeah. Consciously, you buy the game and you're like, this is free. It's no big
deal.
Well,
you're not buying the game. That's the thing. You're consciously downloading a game for free.
Yeah.
And every time I download a free game, the first thing I say is, I'm not going to spend money on this. I'm not going to spend money on this. And then you're playing and you're like, I just want to get better.
Your mouse just somehow moves to the buy button.
Number one, not always a mouse. A lot of these are mobile games, man. Like, you're on a phone. Yep. You know what I mean? You're playing this on a phone. And then all of a sudden, you're like into it. And then it's like, hey, this gold pack, normally $19.99 because you're a first-time user, is $4.99.
It's like, it's such a good deal. I need this right now.
Yeah, but it's like, man, I want to, like, level my guy up so fast. So
Hearthstone's gotten me with that.
$5.
Yep.
I'll spend $5. And then all of a sudden, there's a weekly deal on their store page saying you can spend $4.99, $9.99, and you'll get all this stuff when it's usually $20 or $50 or whatever. And it just becomes a never-ending cycle that you have to break. So I try to stay away from them because I do have a little bit of a competitive side in me, in which when I play these games, I want to be the best. And if it means you have to spend some money to do it, I probably will. And that's a problem. So I don't do it as much as I used to. So I just buy games now from, like, small companies, indie games. If you check out my
gotta support them indie channel, games. Gotta support the indie games.
Yeah, yeah. You'll see some of the games that I've been playing, and most of them are preview games that you can, you know, put some say into how the game's going. And they're not expensive. They're like $10 to $20. So, and they support up and coming companies that are trying to compete quality games in all different levels. So, you know, those are the types of games you want to check out because they're fun, they're inexpensive, and you also can have a say in how the game goes if you have some good ideas, because they're going to want your feedback, you know. So, I mean, it's ingenious because, you know, in the past, people would have to have testers test and play these games, and they'd pay those people for it. Now
they just release them for free. Yeah. Yep.
Now, no, not even for free. You're paying to have early access to a game that's not finished.
Oh, gotcha.
You have the ability to give back to them.
Yep.
You know, in regards to some stuff, mm-hmm. what you think the game should be. But, I mean, this is the new world. I mean, I still remember when you bought a game for whatever price it was, you finished the game and you were done.
Well, that's like, even
there was no DLC, there was no multiplayer or whatever. It was just
sat in a shelf.
At least local. It was local.
Yeah, it just sat in a shelf. And you know, honestly, the nowadays too, with the community and the communication of video games, it's ridiculous. Like, you go on Reddit and there's people from, like, Riot. If you go to, like, League of Legends, right? If you go on their Reddit, their subreddit, or Hearthstone, or literally any video game, you'll have people from the developers and publishers that are confirmed that they work there, and they're commenting on Reddit posts, asking questions, taking feedback, and, you know, they all release betas and stuff to get feedback, but they're actually going out in the community just on their computer like, oh, you guys are complaining about this? All right, let me see if I can fix it. And that's one of the coolest things about, you know, games today, is that that feedback is just, like, instantaneous. It just happens so quickly now. So, all right. Let's get into Tencent a little bit, which we kind of alluded to. I don't particularly know who. I didn't know much about Platinum Games. I actually made a comment to Joe before this podcast that it was weird to me that Platinum Games made Bayonetta. So, have you played Bayonetta, Joe? Or have you heard of it?
I've heard of it. Never played it.
So, I've played it and heard of it. It's a great game. It's one of the better games from Square Enix. Square Enix is one of my favorite video game companies in that they made Final Fantasy. And I love Final Fantasy. But I had no idea who Platinum Game was. And they apparently worked with Square Enix on Bayonetta. They were, I don't want to say bought out, but I guess they're in a capital tie-up, whatever the heck that means in business language, with Tencent Holdings. And Tencent owns Riot. They own a lot of other game publishers and developers. This basically makes Tencent was already the biggest one, but Tencent is like, I've been using the term the Amazon of video games right now. They're literally buying up any gaming company you can imagine, and they're offering. So Amazon, if for all you Amazon folks out there, I'm sure everybody listening has an Amazon Prime account. And I think I told you this too about their logo, Joe. The smile, right?
Oh, yeah.
So the smile, everybody's like, yeah, the logo's a smile. Well, the Amazon logo is not just a smile. It also, the smile goes from the A to the Z. So their whole pitch is they're selling everything from A to Z. And right now, Tencent is pretty much having every game type out there from A to Z. And they're doing well at every game type. They just, if you look at the Riot Games announcements back in October, there was a video on it. We'll put a link below in the description if you're checking out the YouTube video as well. That they announced like a shooter, an RPG, a card game, Legends of Runeterra, which should be out soon. More stuff for League of Legends. That's a MOBA. So literally every game genre, they have something coming out right now. So I don't know. I mean, what do you think about it, Joe? Do you think that there's some concern to be had? I mean, there's the Platinum Games side where people are like, well, is Platinum Games going to be as good? And apparently the president said our company's independence will not be changed. So, you know, the whole spiel from the president. But does that concern you a little bit that Tencent's becoming that big of a company right now in video games?
You know, it's always concerning when you have a company that starts like kind of absorbing multiple companies just because, you know, because
I can
want that competitive spirit. You want all that stuff. I think that we've had those things happen before. You know, I believe back in the day, a lot of people were afraid of EA because EA was picking apart a lot of smaller companies and bringing them on board. I think one of the biggest ones was Sims. I remember when The Sims was really big and EA decided to buy the company.
I forgot that Sims wasn't EA. I totally forgot that. Wow. Okay. Yep.
It was Maxis Games originally.
Yeah. I remember now. Yep. Hey, yep, wait. Didn't Maxis make Civilization too?
I think so. I could be wrong. That I'm not 100% on. I'd have to double check that. But I believe originally Sims was made by Maxis Games. It was bought by EA. That was like one of the big ones where everyone was worried about it. And since then, they've had 4 iterations and now 150 million different expansion packs for them.
Oh, yeah. So, yep.
But there was fear with them. But you know what? You say that, but then you look at Microsoft. You look at their E3 press conference, and you say to yourself, wow, they brought in a lot of independent companies. They're buying a lot of companies. They were doing that last year. The same thing's happening at EA. The same thing's happening at Microsoft. It's happening everywhere. The big boys are buying up the little guys. And in some respects, it's bad. Some respects, it's good because, hey, the little guys are getting brought up to the big leagues. Think of it like if we're going to talk about esports, right? If there were a minor leagues of esports and then the big esports companies said, you know what, we're going to pay you guys and bring you on board to our team. Those little guys now are making a decent salary. They're not just making it off of winning the tournaments. So
you think it's actually helping? But you think it's actually helping overall?
But I think as long as they keep the, you know, the freedom, like he said, the independent freedom of being able to have that dynamic thought process of what can we bring to the table creatively to make games better, to make games more interactive, to make them more fun, really. I mean, because that's the end of the day why we do this, right? We don't do this because we're just trying to burn time. We play video games because it's fun, it's interesting.
Escapism. We're interacting. Escapism, brah.
In a sense, too, yeah, but you're also, like, immersed in a story. That's, like, people read books and stuff like this. Mm-hmm. And you know what? I hate the fact that people blast video games for all different types of reasons, especially because of the fact that you lack imagination by playing these games. Because read a book, because you're only reading the written word, so it's your mind that is creating the story.
All shootings ever were because of Grand Theft Auto 5.
Oh, my God. That's for another podcast.
That's an entire podcast.
That's going to be our special on why people shouldn't believe that.
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
So much more goes into it, but that's like a different podcast for a different day. But I think that there's your good and your bads, you know what I mean? I think that as long as the companies that are buying them are willing to give them their freedom still to be able to create content that people want.
Well, didn't Microsoft
be about monetizing it?
Didn't Microsoft make some sort of subdivision or something to support indie developers?
Well, yeah, they did. And, you know, they have a platform on the Xbox system where you can buy indie games.
Yeah, okay, that's right. All right.
And that's great. And they do end up buying companies that are successful or have great ideas, like I said before. But it all comes down to, can you make it great, and can you not shove like marketing down people's throats of saying you have to buy this stuff to play it properly or to play it at the best level. Stop with the crate, stop with the pay to win. You want to buy skins and things that make your guy look cooler that don't affect the actual gameplay. You know what? Everyone likes style, so I'm fine with that. That's your self-control. That's your choice. But I think you got to stop selling things where people can level their characters up in seconds by spending a couple $100s. You know what I mean? And that's why people are out on Warcraft, because Warcraft became the same way. You know, you can pay to get a character to level 60 or to level 100 if you want. Start the game off where everyone else is versus grinding from one to wherever.
You know what really started that? I remember the very first days of RuneScape selling RuneScape accounts and mm-hmm. Diablo selling items on Diablo. And then Diablo 3 came out. They screwed that up when Diablo 3 came out with that auction house. But that's another podcast.
Yep. I have a friend who sold eBay accounts. He sold accounts on eBay, and he was successful at it for a little bit.
Spore, by the way. We were thinking about, I said Civilization, but Spore was actually what they also made before they got bought out. So,
all right, so that means, guys, don't flame us in the comments about being wrong about something. You know, so we will be making mistakes. A lot of this stuff's going to be off the cuff when we talk about stuff and just things that we remember in our heads about the past of video game lore. So
there's a lot of it.
It is.
So, and actually just to kind of review all this real quick. So if any of you guys, I mean, we're talking about how big Tencent is, but just to put it into everybody's perspective, they own Riot Games, which is, I mean, Riot, everybody knows Riot by now. They make League of Legends, biggest MOBA in the world, and which is arguable with Dota. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then Teamfight Tactics. I know everybody said, well, what about Dota? Well, yeah, League of Legends has way more of an esports, presence.
So you know, I don't play Dota either. But
I played it a couple times.
It's a big deal.
Teamfight Tactics is now the auto chess battler. Like, auto chess came onto the scene, and then Riot's just like, nah, we're going to do this way better than you guys. So that's huge. And then they also have a 40%, no, this is Tencent again. So Tencent owns Riot. They have a 40% stake in Epic Games, which is Fortnite. So we're just talking about Fortnite. That's number one on the list. And then Unreal Engine is also owned by Epic Games. Okay. And Unreal Engine is in freaking everything. Doesn't CSGO use Unreal Engine now?
I'm not sure.
I think I could be wrong. I think I heard that somewhere, but I'm not a huge CSGO guy. I've always been Halo. I'm not so much CSGO and Call of Duty. So, they also have an 80% stake in Supercell, which is like the premium, mobile developer. They do Clash of Clans and Clash Royale.
Okay.
And they also have, which I didn't know this, which blows my mind, they have minority stakes in Activision and Ubisoft. And we all know who those are. If you don't, I suggest watching a different podcast. if you don't know who Activision and Ubisoft are.
Listen to a different podcast, watch a different YouTube channel.
And then come back.
What he meant to say there. But, yeah, listen. it is what it is.
But what's funny about that is that Activision is owned by Blizzard. And Blizzard and Riot are very much like, you know, they go after each other as far as games are concerned and going after consumer attention. So I think it's funny that they kind of have their hands in the pot there a little bit. So, yeah. So, I mean, Tencent is here. They're here to stay. And I just hope it is all good. Like you said, Joe, your outlook was kind of good on it. I'm hoping that it just breeds more good game content, you know? So, all right. So, yeah, honestly, again, with Tencent owning everything right now, just becoming huge, they also have huge news that's been coming out. So by the time you guys all listen to this podcast, they'll have already released a few days worth of news in their 7-day period. So Riot Games actually released a season 2020 trailer, and they will be over the next 7 days. So that was this past Thursday. 7 days from that Thursday, every day they'll be releasing new news. Wow, that's a tongue twister. New news. And but by the time this comes out, the Legends of Runeterra news will have come out. So hopefully there's a beta drop date by then. I am souped for that game. I'm going to be making some YouTube content on it and playing the hell out of that game. And I know Joe is wicked souped to actually get on it too, so we can actually play the game together for once, yep. Play a card game together. And then the next few days, there'll be some more news on, season 2020 stuff. So some hype there. But I don't know, Joe, is there anything you want to add to the this first podcast?
No, I just want to thank everyone who decided to take the chance on us and listen. And I hope, in the coming weeks, you listen some more and we get some good stuff going on. It's going to be bonkers when June comes and we have E3 and stuff like that.
Just
beginning of the year. And so there's a lot that could still happen in the next 6 months before we actually get to E3. But with all the new systems dropping at the end of this year, I know that I'm at least getting the Xbox One X. Depending on where my numbers are, maybe I'll get a PS5 as well. But I got.
Oh, we're getting both. We're getting both. We have to. I want to get both.
I'm a huge Xbox guy. I do have all the systems. I'm really pumped about everything that's going on, and I want to just thank everyone who decided to listen to this podcast. We hope that you enjoyed us enough to give us a 5-star rating and a positive review. Like I said, we will have stuff in the comments about all of the links and everything in the description. And then if you guys have comments or you want to add stuff, we are going to try to be active in that and respond to you guys as well. So we really appreciate you guys taking the time to listen to us. That's all I got. Hope you have a great weekend. Go 49ers. They're playing on Saturday.
With the 49ers.
We're recording this podcast on a Saturday. So hopefully when you're listening to this on
Monday. We specifically needed to record this at 1 p.m. so that Joe could watch the 49ers game. So
yeah, because I can't miss it. So
and also,
hopefully,
do not
when
forget
to this, the 49ers are in the NFC Championship game.
Honestly, I'm rooting for them now because the Pats are screwed. So
right. I know we're a video game podcast and about sports, but we're gonna be talking a lot of esports and Madden.
Hey, sports is sports, man.
but Madden is probably one of the bigger tournaments out there. So. Go Niners, and once again, thank you everyone who decided to take the time to listen and take a chance on Game Wild.
Definitely, and check out the YouTube channel. So it's going to be Game Wild on YouTube. Hit it up. This will be uploaded as well, so you can actually see myself and Joe's ugly mugs on the interwebs. It'll be awesome.
Have a link in the description to our YouTube channel as well.
Yes, yeah, we'll probably be doing more with that. So so there's more than just us talking. Obviously, we can put some additional stuff in the YouTube.
We'll probably put some of our cool Twitch stream stuff on it if we have any good stuff on Twitch. We'll put stuff on there. All the good stuff.
Cool stuff for coming. So,
All
right, everybody, thank you very much. Have a great week this week, and we'll see you next week.
Peace out.
Later.